turn this option off. Let's go into edit mode while having selected this part, the one that we have just unparented. Now, go to the face selection mode, press numpad 3. Then what you want to do, you want to press any bit, you select any face on the part you want to separate. Like I want to separate the upper clothing. So you select any bit of any face. Then you press control numpad plus and it will automatically select all the connected faces just like that. You press it continually until it engulfs the entire mesh. Okay, now that we've done that, you press P for separation, P, then you separate by selection. Then you go into the object mode. And as you can see, it's now separated. See? Just like that. Then you repeat the process. Take the head, for example. You press this part that has not been separated in the object mode. Go back to edit mode. Select a couple of faces. Then control numpad plus. It will select the connected faces. You press P and you separate by selection. And now it is an individual mesh. Just like that. Then you repeat this process for all the parts that have not been separated. Control plus, number P, separate. You go into the object mode. The face shield is now a different part. Then you repeat this process. Let's go to the tank. Select this part, this bit that has not been separated. You go to P, select a face, control plus, P by selection, and go back to object mode, separated. You do it till you separate all the bits that should be separate, because even when you come to rigging, you don't want bits that are supposed to be separate to be fused together. That will cause a whole lot of problems. That's one thing you have to be mindful of. You have to do this process until you make sure that you have separated the parts that are connected. You make sure that they are separate units. Let's pick this part to the, let's go to the edit mode. Select a face or a couple of faces, doesn't matter. Then control plus, it will automatically select the connected faces. Then you press P by selection, just like that, and this is a separate mesh. And just like that, Blender will have an easier time when rigging this character. And one pro tip I can give you, if you don't want to struggling with the mesh coming through, the clothing when you've done rigging and you're trying to animate, these parts of the character that are not going to be seen are supposed to be deleted, or you have two separate meshes, one that has that's basically what you're supposed to do. It will be easier for animation, and also it will be easier on your system because it won't consume too much unnecessary space. Okay, so basically you have to go, after you're done doing that, you have to rename these parts rename these parts appropriately so that you don't get confused. It will be even easier for the rigger to understand the part he's working with. So that's basically how you do it. You have to be patient. You have to know the parts that you want to be separate.